If you are new to D&D, then this video is going to be perfect for you. Now, I lived that dream. I went and played D&D for the very first time. Capture my thoughts just before I played the game. Be honest, pretty nervous. Played lots of games before and never felt the way I'm feeling right now. I think because D&D, Dungeons and Dragons, it's such a well-known IP with so much love out there for it. It's incredible. And here I am about to play my very first game. I understand be rolling dice, I understand there's gonna be lots of story, but I don't know. Now, after I've played the game, look, these are gonna be the five things that I learned from playing D&D for the very first time. Number one, and that is gonna be open mindfulness to truly embrace your inner creativity. Now, when you're first starting out, you're gonna think that the story is based on the dungeon master, the DM, the person who's telling the story, and how creative are their storytelling talents? But this is only a small portion of this holistic picture. Now, you must rely on your own vivid imagination to get fully immersed in this story. It doesn't matter how impressive the storyteller DM is, it's you that's going to turn those particular words into a vibrant and rich world in your mind. So you have to fill in those blanks. So let's say that the DM tells you that you and your band of characters are about to walk into a temple high up on the hill there. How large is the temple? What are the colors? What are the characters moving around? Are there any characters moving around? What are the artifacts littered around the room? You are given a canvas, but your mind will truly paint that picture. Number two, and that is character creation is so overwhelming. Now let's not muck around here. Look, character creation is going to be the most overwhelming aspect for any new player getting into Dungeons and Dragons. Look, there is so much stuff on here. It's incredible. Now the starter set is going to give you pre-filled character sheets, which is a start, but how do you turn the terminology, those random numbers, into something of substance that you can actually work with? Now, look, like I said, these starter sets are so invaluable as it will, I guess it will balance the characters and attempt to explain the meanings of some of these sections. But the remainder, though, is a lot of assumed knowledge, and new players will still feel that sense of, I am completely out of my depth. Well, this particular set in Dragons of Stormwreck Isle, look, you're gonna get five character sheets already pre-filled in. Now, I would love to see even more basic character sheets with more explanations on there. How about having a set for very first players that might only have maybe half of this information on there? Get them to learn the basics. Then after the first chapter, maybe then you give them the second sheet and that will give them the other half of the information and slowly give them that all that information for them to feel comfortable. I sat there thinking, I have equipment on here. How and when do I use that? I have saving throws. What are saving throws? I have down here passive wisdom. How is that any different to normal wisdom? I have on the back here, I have different levels that I'm going to upgrade to. I don't know anything about this. So how about easing us new players by slowly drip feeding character information sheets throughout the chapters of their campaign? I think that way it just wouldn't have been so in my face. Number three, and background in board games can only help you so much. I've played hundreds and hundreds of board games, and out of those, I've played multiple campaign storytelling board games. And none of those truly prepared me for D&D. the closest thing, I guess, modern board games have with RPGs is a campaign-style board game like Sleeping Gods. Now, Sleeping Gods is my number two, I think it's my number two board game of all time at the moment. So, look, I love myself some Sleeping Gods. Sleeping Gods is an RPG where you're invested in the world, exploring, interacting with the world around you. The story is deep and engaging like D&D. So what actually separates those games? Well, the difference in modern board game RPGs is that the world is visually portrayed right there in front of you. Perhaps there's a map to portray the different aspects of the terrain. Perhaps it's a physical dungeon that you're going to be moving your characters around. Perhaps it's a story that has pictures or cards to show you the items and your enemies. D&D more closely resembles the feelings of a book. The characters you chat to and the world you explore is based solely on how your imagination sees this world. This will flow nicely onto my observation number four. And number four is you are heavily reliant on the right type of players around the table. Now, modern board games, you can get away with all sorts of different personalities because a lot of times, maybe you're playing like almost a solo game. But in D&D, I will never play this game without the right type of players going forward. Look, those people need to be truly committed to let go of their inhibitions and dive deep into their character. So don't be reserved, buy into the story, build out your character with these worlds, and everyone will have fun. That way, look, everyone will feel the same raw emotion of your character as you do. The more that people buy into it, the better the experience will be, and just even one player who's not truly in will ruin the night for everyone. So I do want RPGs, and in fact, I want all board games to be as inclusive as possible, but you definitely do need, I guess, the right people who are going to leave those inhibitions at the door. They're going to leave their biases, their preconceived ideas, and you're really a team. You're a team living this dream together, so embrace it. Number five, and that is attacking and rolling the dice is not going to be your only highlight of the night. Now look, I get it. There's that preconceived idea out there of like nerdy teenagers sitting behind, like in their basement, sitting playing Dungeons and Dragons, rolling dice. But that notion scares a lot of people off from actually trying and experiencing what this game actually is. So yeah, your first, very first milestone is going to be rolling that dice and attacking. And it's a great milestone, don't get me wrong. I was a wizard and I chose a spell, I can't remember what it was, maybe Thunder Wave or something like that. Wait, I rolled a d20. All of a sudden, DM says to me, you've got a hit. Amazing, cool, job done. Oh no, I've got to roll again. Wait, what, I'm rolling again? Cool, I roll another dice, I now cause some hits. I'm like, this is amazing. But that was it, that was the first moment. But it wasn't really till I got to the end of the night, as the night wound down, that I truly appreciated what happened before me. Now let's just use an example. It's the openness of the world that I'm trying to express right now. So we went up to this temple and we were met by the keeper, and this temple is from the dragon of Bahamut. Now this keeper is sort of telling us this story, and it's from those moments I'm like, what questions do I want to ask? I've got all these questions going through my head. Should I be exploring this temple? What is the history of this temple? What's it trying to tell me? And it is those questions that constantly linger throughout the whole story. Now that is the true highlight of this game. Well, look, definitely attacking and rolling dice is amazing. I think it's the openness and being able to ask any question you want, I think is that true highlight. I have played D&D for the very first time and I get it. I actually get why people are hooked on this. Now, let's finish off this video by doing a little mini review on this starter set, Dragons of Stormwreck Isle. Now, realistically, I have no right to review this game. I've never played another D&D game. I have no baseline to compare this game to. But what I can compare it to is something I mentioned, Sleeping Gods. Now, Sleeping Gods is that campaign board game that I play and absolutely love. If you're a D&D fan, then you're probably going to enjoy this experience as well, because that immersive storytelling is such a large element of this game. So I can compare it to a modern board game RPG, but I can't compare it to other D&D games. So hopefully that makes sense. Now, the first thing I want to talk about is, you know, if you're a new player, is this game right for you? And the obvious answer is, of course it is. It's a starter set. But I think the answer is more nuanced than that. Now, when you're starting out, you're going to get these character sheets right here. Oh, who we got? Let's grab maybe Hootery Bob. Got Hootery Bob. Yeah, one of my friends played with Hootery Bob at the time of their life. But what Hootery Bob gives you is a whole bunch of information, a whole bunch of stats, a whole bunch of words that just don't make any sense to someone starting out. And that's why every single person playing should have a chance to read some of the basics of this rulebook. Now, the rulebook is going to talk about a lot of the different terminology and why those numbers actually matter. So what I would say is, if you're planning a night and you know you have new players, new beginners, give them the chance to have a look over that rulebook. Don't let them, like, it's that whole sink or swim. Don't let them sink. Give them a chance to swim, and by giving them some of those rules. Now, it's still going to be quite overwhelming. There's a lot in that book, and then you get the character sheet. There's a lot of information here, but it's still the easiest way right now that D&D offers you to get into the game. So for that reason, of course, the starter set is right. Now, what do you get in it? You get a whole bunch of dice. Now, look, I can't compare these starter dice. They look nice. They feel good. Look, everything you need is here. You've got those five character sheets. Now, I would have loved to see some more. So now we've drawn on it and we've created it. How do I play it again? I probably should have photocopied them before I started. But again, little things I didn't know when I was playing this game. Now, you have the book that tells you the story. And again, you're going to need someone who has a little bit of experience to be able to drive that narrative. And look, it was a great story. I really enjoy it. I'm not going to give you spoilers, but I'll give you the starting point. You're going to arrive on this boat, and you know, already the name Stormwreck Isle is a bit of a concern there, a bit disconcerting. But you arrive on this boat, and the first thing that's going to happen is these three zombies are going to come towards you. Now, this is your very first moment to make that decision. Do you stand there and attack within like the first, you know, 30 seconds of the game? Or do you run off like a scared little, you know, school kid or something? Well, we chose the school kid option and we ran off, and that was how our story started. But it was an incredible night. A lot of people really enjoyed this, and I think for that reason, this story was a great starting point for D&D. Now, the question I would ask is, would I play it again? And of course I would play it again. I love that narrative. I love that immersive world that I am digging so deep into. Like, in my head, I'm creating all these visions of what I'm seeing. And the people around the table are all creating their own visions, so they're all living their own story. It was a fascinating, fascinating world, and I can see now why people absolutely love this game. So, but here's the question. Would I go back to board games, or would I prefer this? I think deep down, I'm into board games. I'm a board gamer. That's who I am. But geez, give me something else. I wanna try some RPGs. Like, I love things like, what do we got around here? Lands of Galzea, where we're animals and we're in an animal world. So I'm gonna be keeping an eye out for some RPGs where, like, maybe I'm like in an animal world, because that sounds fascinating to me. So I think there's enough out there. If you have any sort of interest, there's gonna be an RPG for you. But definitely start off with this, just to get the core concepts of what an RPG is, and you're ready to go. So again, it was such a mini review. Look, all you get in here is the book, the rule book, the five character sheets, bunch of dice here, and that's all you have. And for what it is, I think it was an amazing experience. So there we go. Hopefully you enjoyed these five things, these five lessons I learned from playing D&D for the very first time. And I hope you loved my little mini review at the end. Again, I'm hoping to get myself my hands on a lot more of these copies out there. And maybe I can do some more of these videos if you like it. So make sure you leave a comment to let me know you actually want more RPG content on this channel, and I can do that. More than happy to do it, but I need you to tell me that. While you're at it, how about a simple little cheeky subscription to my channel, because that would kind of make my day, really help me along and get these videos out to more and more people. Anyway, that's it from me. I'm Hoges. This is the Bangers Project. This is Dungeons & Dragons Starter Set, Dragons of Stormwreck Isle. Till next time, laters.